SeaWorld's court battle is heating up in Seminole County. It's challenging an OSHA finding that it willfully violated safety guidelines in February of 2010 in the death of trainer Don Brancho. West 2's Dave McDaniel is live outside the Seminole County Courthouse. And Dave, there have been some testy exchanges this afternoon.
Well, there have been between OSHA's lead attorney and Chuck Tompkins, who when it comes to SeaWorld, he is the trainer's trainer. He knows so much about whales, and he trains the people who trains those whales. Tompkins is telling the court that basically his folks know so much about SeaWorld and killer whale behavior that they can almost predict those behaviors before they happen. But the OSHA attorney is saying that for the people injured or worse, it's a system far from perfect. With more than 20 years at SeaWorld, Chuck Tompkins believes he knows whales, how to train them, and how to train the people who train them. He says all trainers are heavily coached and supervised, and that they can watch whales and predict nearly every behavior. The OSHA attorney pushed him to admit it doesn't always work. OSHA believes only barriers between trainers and whales meets the safety standard. Tompkins said with more than 1.6 million interactions, resulting in 100 incidents and only 12 injuries over the past 20-some years, shows training succeeds within a tick of 100% of the time. The OSHA attorney said he didn't want to be the tick. Early in the day, OSHA showed home video of Dawn Brancho in the moments before she was pulled under. It's video we've seen before, with her low in the shallow area of the pool in front of Tillicum, a whale requiring special safety rules even before this incident. OSHA pushed a security officer say Brancho was grabbed by the arm, not the ponytail, as SeaWorld has said.
Unlike what SeaWorld says, he didn't grab her ponytail. As you can see now with the evidence and the eyewitnesses that are coming forward, he already had her arm in his mouth, and he was moving, and he took her down from there.
The Orca Project, an organization formed after Brancho's death, says if she was pulled in by her arm, it proves problems in SeaWorld safety.
Just proves that these sentient, intelligent beings don't belong in tiny little pools when they swim over 100 miles a day with their family.
The Brancho family sat in court watching the video while it played. Tompkins testified this afternoon to the court that his people know so much about whale behavior that not only do they know it, they can alter it, they can interrupt bad behavior. And he also pointed out that even though they document every single time a whale gets out of line or deviates from the normal, he says rarely does that deviation ever become aggressive. Reporting live at the Seminole County Courthouse, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.